A visually impaired woman, Mohammed Zainab, has lost all her belongings, including the 150 Ghana cedis she had struggled to save to pay for her daughter's fees. In a confused state, she tries to gather her thoughts to make sense. She says she's lost everything, including where to sleep and what to eat.
I don't know where to stay. The rain has destroyed everything. My daughter is a student and I raised 150 Ghana cedis. The water carried it away. She was supposed to have left for school tomorrow, but I can't raise that money again. We are appealing for help. We do not even have food to eat and no shelter.
A pregnant woman, Alhassan Salama, to said she lost everything, an item she had gathered for her marriage ceremony. According to her, her husband was interested in helping rescue them instead of the items, and somebody picked the bag and emptied it.
When the flood occurred, my husband's focus was to rescue myself in the case. So he was able to carry us on his neck through the raging water to safety. As for our animals, the water carried it away. The bag containing my clothes, someone stole it. And even the clothes I'm wearing, it had been given to me by a kind person.
Given the extent of the disaster, the Member of Parliament for the Kumbungu constituency, Dr. Hamza Adams, has been touring some communities in the constituency. He attributed the floods to the construction of the Tonongbolong Road. Dr. Hamza said government must resource the National Disaster Management Organization to be able to reach out to people in distress.
We have been told that the flooding has occurred as a result of the construction of the Kumbungu-Beleng Road. During the construction, the contractor did not make enough drain. It did not create enough drains for water to pass through. So as a result of that, the water has been blocked, resulting in the flooding of the entire community. I want to believe that if actions or steps are not taken to attend to this, the resulting consequences will be very sad to talk about. So I want to appeal to Highways. Highways must immediately call the contractor back to site. And I think one thing I said and I want to stress is that NADMO is not given the needed resources. So government must take steps to provide resources to NADMO so that once they have the capacity to provide, I'm sure they will not have any excuse to drag their feet when the situation arises.